paying attention. They worked with me anyway.
Yeah. But I mean, things are much happier now with
you. Oh, things are wonderful. I think that's why I had the courage to try and do music that was more contemporary and especially avant-garde. It's hard, you know, Terry, because you get, if you're well-known for something and you're safe, do you know what I mean? Then to make a huge move in a different direction is a bit scary. And you have to risk some people not liking it. And it took me this long to take that risk, because I've always loved pop music. Also, I think it happened in the right way, because I don't think I would have been able to do it as well without the Pet Shop Boys.
Well, look, we'll welcome them.
Oh, yes.
One of our most successful duettists, whose records and concerts have not only been greeted by popular, but by critical acclaim. And they've just teamed up with Liza Langer, their new album. The album's called Results.
Yes.
Yeah. So let's meet them. It's Chris Lowell and Neil Tennant, the Pet Shop Boys. So tell us, how did the project come about in the first place?
Well, our manager, Tom Watkins, who also manages the group Bros, you might have heard of, he was in New York talking to their record company. Liza was actually on the same label as Bros. And they started talking to him about, you know, by how they'd signed Liza, and they were looking for producers. And the guy at the American record company was a big fan of ours. And Tom said, why do you get the other boys to do it? And he came back to England and said, you'll never guess who wants to work with you. I said, who? And he said, Liza Minnelli.
But really, it wasn't just thrust upon you. You heard him and decided you wanted to work with him?
I had heard a song called Rent.
Yeah.
And I had asked I said, who is that? And who wrote that? And who's singing that? And they said, these two guys. So I said, well, what are they called? And they told me the Pet Shop Boys. Then there's like an intermission of a couple of months. Now I hear that maybe the Pet Shop Boys will do my album, produce it and write it. And I just went crazy. I thought it was so wonderful.
Well, it's a challenge for everybody, because you said you haven't done any pop.
Yeah.
And a challenge for you. I mean, were you apprehensive about it?
No. Not normally apprehensive about things. We're just looking forward to it, because, you know, we really like Liza Minnelli, and it's always good when you're working with someone that's like a huge star, which is something we get off on as well, you know. It's like it.
So, I mean, you've written 5 new songs.
Yeah.
For this Results. Were they all written with Liza in mind?
Yeah, I mean, particularly with the music, we just made sure it was the kind of music that we like. We didn't, I think maybe some people at the record company thought we'd try and make it middle of the road, but we didn't see Liza, not having met her, as that kind of artist. We knew that she was quite happy to do something that was kind of brave and that was, you know, now. But with the lyrics, because I wrote most of the lyrics, you know, I was writing them with Liza in mind. So the song Liza's just done, So Sorry I Said, was written for, you know, and I know quite a bit about Liza, a woman of Liza's age and experience, and that is a fascinating thing to do. And also, I know she's an actress, and she can interpret it in the right way.
Well, she did.
Yeah.
You know, it's so funny, I walked in, I mean, I've never made a pop album, right? So I thought, the Pet Shop Boys, oh great, now what'll I wear? That was always good. I knew that I was gonna be fine, because Neil and Chris would look after all the music. I thought, what should I wear? And I got out this, do you remember this stupid skirt? This little leather skirt, and I arrived. I said, hi guys, you know, and I'd heard all the songs and everything. This is the first session. And after about an hour, I said, when did the musicians get here? And they said, don't be mad. I said, what are you talking about? There are no musicians. There's just all these machines and us. And I was stuck in that outfit all day. I thought I was going to meet the rock musicians. You know?
You find it different working with simple souls like these two chaps?
They're the most complicated people I've ever worked with.
I can believe that.
Because they won't compromise on anything, which is great, because that's the way I like to work.
It can't all mean sweetness and light, though. There must have been a bit of fighting.
Sorry to tell you this.
Come along now.
Well, I'm afraid there's no dirt to dish, actually, on the... I know it's not very good value, but Chris. Actually, it was Winston Light.
No.
It's always been a joy to work with Liza.
Oh, get off.
There'll be no problems.
I'm sorry we had you now.
She and Chris taught each other dance steps, so they exchanged dance steps.
Yes, we would dance in between things, and then we'd go out and sit and have lunch and watch all these television shows like yours.
God help us. Now, what about you? We must talk about your European tour. Is that... Are we still in the throes of that? Has that finished?
No, we just finished. In fact, we originally were doing a tour of the Far East. We've never done a tour before, and we decided we would do Britain as well. So it was a 14-day tour of Hong Kong, Japan, Britain.
A theatrical extravaganza.
Yeah, we've never done a tour before because we're a bit disenchanted with the normal rock concert format, and we've always wanted to do something that was a real production that kept your interest all the way through. And so we had a director, Derek Jarman, the film director, who's also working on stage. He directed the whole performance, and he made 8 films which are shown during it. And we had a team of dancers from Los Angeles who worked with Michael Jackson a lot. And so it all kind of came together like that.
Did you see the show?
No, I missed it by, 4 days or something like that?
I didn't get a ticket for that one either.
We keep sending them to you, Derek.
I mean, you like pop music, though. I mean,
Have you? I've always liked it. I grew up with one kind of music, but I've always listened to a different kind of music. And I was just scared to do it before.
Yeah. Did you play this music to Frankie and Sammy? And
oh, yes.
They hated it.
We all hung out together. That was pretty funny.
Go on.
I mean, it was like culture shock for all of us. I mean, I would be singing at the Albert Hall, and I'd work with the guys all day long. And then, you know, we'd go to the theater. On opening night, it was wonderful.
Well.
Then we'd go to a club,
That's what Liza about raping,
Yeah.
Actually, the only problem on the whole album was that Chris and I, neither of us owns a tuxedo. And we had dinner after seeing the concert with Frank Sinatra and Sammy Davis Jr. and Liza. And we got a call in the afternoon saying, it's at the Savoy, you've got to wear a tuxedo. And Chris and I don't have one. And
so the poverty,
Savoy,
is it?
The Savoy kindly gave us... it's attitude, I think.
Oh, is he attitude, huh?
The Savoy kindly gave us permission not to have to wear black tie.
It was a big deal.
It was a big deal, actually. But Frank Sinatra was very nice about it, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was. Well, he thought you were terrific. He loved all the music. And so did Sammy.
I mean, would you write for Frank Sinatra?
Well, in the next 20 minutes?
Not immediately. I mean, I'm not offering or anything. I just thought, wondered if all...
Well, if he asked us, we'd consider it, I think,
Would you? Yeah. I mean, it is a transition for you, for both of you as well, isn't it? What makes you want to do that? Well, I mean, obviously, everybody wants to move forward, but very few pop idols or groups move in this particular direction.
Well, it's just, I mean, we've done a couple of things with other people before, and we always work with people, you know, who we're interested in. And when we suggested that Liza would like to work with us, she's someone who Chris and I are both fascinated by. I mean, to me, she was part of pop music, because in the early 70s, I was a fan of David Bowie and Roxy music, and Liza Minnelli with Cabaret was all part of the same sort of movement at the time. And since then, I've always been fascinated by Liza Minnelli. And to have someone, you know, a singer and star of that stature will come and sing your songs, I mean, it's something you don't get offered very often.
But it is a risk not only for you, but it's a risk for you too as well. I mean,
well, Paul Russell, who's the head of Epic over here and for CBS over here, said the best compliment to us. He said, when he listened to it, he said, the nicest thing about it is nobody compromised. You know, it's not anything that is different for you. They haven't put any effects on your voice, and the music is as rough as it just wants to be. You know,
so you don't think there'll be any problems about credibility, in inverted commas?
Actually, we think Liza Minnelli is very credible anyway.
Yeah, so do I. Has your voice changed, Liza, do you think?
Well, it's changed with what they did to it. I mean, they made me sing way down here and then way up high. I didn't know I had a lot of the range until Neil just said, well, just do it. Just do it. But he directed me well. You know, at one point I was in the studio, and I was worried about sounding like a rock singer, so I said, time, or something. Do you remember this? And I heard Neil say, what are you doing? And I said, what am I doing, Neil? He said, why are you saying time? Just say time. I said, oh. He said, sing it like you sing an Aznavour song. And I understood exactly what he meant then. Just go for the words and don't try and be like anybody else.
So you're bossy to be around, are you?
Oh, he's wonderful.
I'm famous for being bossy. Ah. Ask Chris.
I'm not, I would, but I don't want to because I want the three of you to actually sing for us. So you're going to do a new single from the album.
Yes, it's by, it's not written by us, this song, actually, it's by Stephen Sondheim. And I first heard this in the show Follies. And it's a great song called Losing My Mind.
Okay, will you do it for us? Thank you.
Okay.
All three, please. Thank you. There's the Pet Shop Boys, Liza Minnelli, and Stephen Sondheim's beautiful song from Follies, Losing My Mind.
Thank you.
I hope we've helped to settle your stomach for the weekend. The Great and the Good on Wednesday at 7 will be the tiny but virtually flawless Kylie Minogue.
Ah, oh, she's swell.
She's a fine big girl. See you then, Blue. Good night. Thank you.
Good night. Thank you.